Missouri Compromise and the Compromise of 1850. In 1918, the balance of slave states and free states was equal, but a problem was forming. A new state, Missouri, wanted to enter the Union, but this would upset the balance between slave states and free states. But then a new bill was proposed. This bill was known as the Missouri Compromise. This bill was proposed by Henry Clay, Kentucky Senator. In the Missouri Compromise, Missouri was to be admitted as a slave state, but in order to offset the number of slave and free states, Maine was admitted as a free state. Missouri Compromise prohibited slavery in the Louisiana Territory north of the parallel 36 degrees 30 minutes, with the exception of Missouri. The first bill was proposed in February 1819, but Missouri did not finally get admitted in the Union until August 10, 1821. Maine had been admitted on March 15, 1821, 5 months before Missouri. In 1850, there were several complications with the Union. The first issue was whether or not the U.S. newly acquired territory from Mexico would allow slavery. The second issue was that California had just been petitioned to enter the Union as a free state, which would in turn upset the balance of free states and slave states. Texas claimed disputed territory that extended all the way to Santa Fe. The final issue was that Washington, D.C. allowed slavery and was the home to the largest slave market in America. Henry Clay, the slave man who proposed the Missouri Compromise, proposed the Compromise of 1850. Beginning with the Texas issue, Texas would give up its territorial disputes, but in turn be given $10 million to pay off its debt to Mexico. The territories of Utah, New Mexico, Arizona, and Nevada were created in the newly acquired land, and slavery would be decided later in those states. California was admitted as a free state, and in order to keep the balance, the Fugitive Slave Act was passed. This act was very controversial. This law required citizens to help locate fugitive slaves. This also took away fugitive slaves' right to trial by jury. In the midst of this, more than 20,000 slaves fled to Canada to escape the Fugitive Slave Act. The compromise lasted for a little while, but truly was not so successful and united the nation as a civil war soon broke out.